Hi children, welcome back to English class. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, I Can Do It. Before getting to the topic, let's look at the works that we can easily do. We can refill our water bottle and we can keep our garden clean. We can tie our shoelaces. We can brush our teeth. We can peel the eggshells. And we can help our parents in many ways. See children, these are all the works that we can do easily. Do you help your parents? Do you help your friends? Do you help your sisters and brothers? How do you help them? Some of you will help your parents for making food. Some of you will help your parents for cleaning the house. Some of you will help your friends for doing their homeworks, right? Okay, do you do some of your work like cleaning your cupboards, folding your clothes, brush your teeth, take bath, like all by yourself? Good. Are you ready to listen? Okay, in this lesson, we will look at a girl named Gina and what are all the work that she can easily do. Let's watch the video, children.
I can help. I can make the sandwich. Gina put some bread and butter on the table. Good, mother said. Let me get a plate. No, said Gina. I can do that.
Tell me. What does mother want to make for Gina? Yes, mother wants to make a sandwich for Gina. What does Gina tell her mother? Gina tells her mother that she can prepare a sandwich. Why does she say that? Because she wants to help her mother. What does Gina need to make the sandwich? She needs a plate and bread and butter. Have you eaten sandwiches? You know, children, the sandwich is so delicious to eat. And it's yummy too.
She took a plate from the cupboard. Then she made her sandwich. Gina ate the sandwich. She poured some juice into a glass and drank it. Then she washed the dishes. Everything is so easy. I can do it all.
Do you understand? Is Gina a helpful girl? Yes. Gina helped her mother. She prepared a sandwich for herself. And she ate the sandwich. Finally, she washed her plates. What do you do after you finish your meals? Will you go to bed? Or will you sleep? Or do you take your plates to the sink? Will you help your parents in such a way? Do you wash your plates? Do you help in clearing the table or cleaning the path where you took your food? Do you think is it a good habit to clean up after we eat? Yes, of course. We have to take all the plates and we have to clean the place where we took food after the eat.
Do you want to go to the park? Asked mother. Yes, mother. Let me put on my shoes, Gina said. Her shoes were under the bed. They were new. The new shoes had laces. I can tie the laces myself, she said. Gina pulled and pushed. She turned the laces this way and that. The laces got twisted. They were twisted in a knot. Gina's face was red. She was angry. She could not tie her laces. Here, let me show you, mother said. Mother showed Gina how to tie her laces. Gina carefully did what her mother said. At last, she pulled the laces tight. "I did it! I can tie my shoelaces," smiled Gina.
What are the four things that Gina does? Shall we remember one by one? First, she put some bread and butter on the table. She took the plate from the cupboard. She ate the sandwich. Finally, she washed her plate. She did everything easy and she said she can do it all. Where Gina and her mother are going? Gina and her mother are going to the park. How Gina tries to tie her laces? She pulls and pushes her laces this and that way, but she couldn't tie her laces, right? So what happened? How her mother shows her to tie her laces? Her mother shows Gina and helps Gina that how to tie her laces. Now, what did Gina learn to do from her mother? Yes, now Gina can able to tie her laces without her mother help. She learned from her mother how to tie her laces. Do you tie your shoes laces without your parent help? What are the two things that Gina knows to do now? The first one is how to make a delicious and yummy sandwich without her mother help, and another one, how to tie her shoelaces without her mother help. What does Gina says to her mother? She says to her mother, "Thank you," because her mother helped Gina to know how to tie her shoelaces. So Gina says thank you to her mother. Yes, my dear children, we must say thank you to others when we get help from others. When someone says thank you to you, you must say you are welcome. Okay, children, what things did Gina put on the table? She put some bread and butter on the table. See, bread and butter. These are words commonly used together, like lock and key, life and death, cup and saucer, salt and pepper. These words are called pad words. With the help of this picture, you want to make pad words. Will you do that? Now, it's a time for activity. Like I said you before, you have to make 10 pad words by your own choices. And you want to prepare a sandwich for your family member. I'll meet you in the next class, children. Thank you.